Welcome everybody to the Dot Video Show with your host, Jesse Pinkman Miller. Welcome to our Halloween episode. I'm glad you guys at home are all wearing your Halloween costumes. You saw everybody in the audience, of course. This isn't really a costume. I have been cooking meth all week. Just had to keep the smell off of my clothes. Welcome to our studio audience. Welcome as always to our millions and billions of internet viewers. Thank you for joining us. We have an incredible episode for you tonight. As you saw, we'll be featuring the DJI Phantom drone and some very cool accessories for it. And don't go away because later, we have from the world champion, Miami Dolphins, some awesome version 2.0 upgraded 120 frame per second 2K footage. That's coming to us right from what they call now Sun Life Stadium, what our friends know as Joe Robbie Stadium, home of the world champion, Miami Dolphins. In between our F55, F5 firmware upgrade and Phantom demonstration, we're gonna feature Genesis cage. It's a GoPro cage to make your disposable cameras indestructible. So, awesome episode coming up for you today. Thank you for joining us. Say hello in the chat room. We will be answering your questions. And we've got a couple of great pieces of footage for you to enjoy. And you know, let's get on with the show. So for starters, let's talk about the DJI Phantom. Now, you've seen this little white quadricopter all over the internet. Most people have the red stripes on the front of their quadricopter, showcasing it as the average run-of-the-mill Phantom. Of course, the Midtown video version has blue stripes because we're running the upgraded board. What does the upgraded board get you? Well, number one, it allows you to integrate the Zenmuse gimbal system, which we're gonna get to in a moment. But another important difference between Midtown Video's Phantom and your average run-of-the-mill Phantom are our rotors. So the regular Phantom copters, all the rotors go in the same direction, which is great if one of the rotors breaks and you need to replace them because they all go the same way. What we're using are the advanced anti-gravity motors, meaning these two rotors go clockwise and these two rotors go counterclockwise. Really important because the prop nuts, which I learned is the technical term for the little device that keeps your propeller stuck to your motor, those actually go counterclockwise because the motors themselves are going counterclockwise. So you need a little bit of inverse torque so that the prop nuts keep the props securely fastened to your motors. A couple of other fancy things we've got going on is one of them's right here. Check this out. This device is a wireless transmitter. Now you notice I've got my GoPro Hero 3 Black, which means I can record 2K, 4K, or HD video from my Phantom, my DJI Phantom quadricopter. But I can also take a standard definition down convert right into this transmitter. That is the footage that you saw a little bit earlier at the beginning of my show. Let me show you what I mean. So that transmitter broadcasts to this here receiver. So, turn the monitor on. I can actually mount this receiver to my remote control transmitter. And then as I'm flying the quadricopter, you'll notice that I've got live video from the copter right on top of my transmitter. So on the one hand, I can be watching the quadricopter and sort of controlling its flight. On the other hand, for the cinematographer in you, you can be framing your shot right here on your wireless receiver. So once again, you are recording in high definition, however, you're only transmitting in standard definition. So you'll notice that we've got the output of the GoPro. It gives me my battery life left, it tells me what frame rate I'm in, all that kind of stuff. So, a few things to consider when flying your DJI Phantoms. Number one, there's an argument out there as to whether or not it's legal to go above 400 feet. Now, you don't need an FAA license to fly one of these quadricopters. However, urban myth or potentially actual fact says that if you fly above 400 feet, you're interfering with FAA airspace. The jury is still out on that, but our recommendation, just don't go above 400 feet and then you'll never have to know whether or not you're breaking the law. Another friend of ours, Chris from Grand River Productions, said, make sure that you let your people know that you can't fly drones for profit. That sounds like a myth. I'm not 100% certain about that one. So, once again, the jury's still out. If you guys want to do some aerial photography, it can be done. One important thing to note, what we've got there is a static GoPro mount, but when it's time to do it for real, I've been trick-or-treating. So out of my candy bucket, I've got here the Zenmuse gimbal, all right? So better than just your static GoPro mount, I can actually attach my GoPro Hero HD 3 right here, my Hero Black, onto this gimbal mount, and this will provide not only gyro stabilization, but also remote tilt control, all right? If you want to see what you can do with remote tilt control, please take a look at Italian cinematographer whose name escapes me, but I'm sure we'll feature it in this clip coming up, as he features Castle Pavone. Wasn't that beautiful, awesome aerial photography featuring the tilt-controllable Zenmuse gimbal? Pretty fantastic. But Jesse, you might say, I live in Miami, or I live in New York, or I live in California or Texas. We don't have centuries-old Italian castles. Well, to feature some work of our friends who don't have castles at hand, we called our friend Felipe Moreau from VTM Productions and said, Felipe, what have you got for us? And so, without further ado, that is our DJI Phantom quadricopter. A little bit that you can do with it. We'll have our the Zenmuse gimbal on hand, so that from the remote control you can control your tilt. If you need flight lessons, if you need to work on your copter, if you need any help like that, come on in and see your friends at Midtown Video. Before we go, a little bit of safety information for you. There is a transmitter and there is a receiver, and number one safety tip, never turn your transmitter off first. We're gonna turn the quadricopter off first. And that's because if your transmitter turns off, on the one hand, you might be receiving RF interference that tells your quadricopter to do funny things. But on the other hand, this quadricopter is enabled with what they call return to home technology. What that means is, if my transmitter were to shut off, because this is GPS enabled and synchronized with satellites in orbiting space, if something catastrophic were to happen to my transmitter, the helicopter is going to be smart enough to ascend to 60 feet, return to its original starting position, and land itself very slowly. Now, we happen to be indoors, and I don't have 60 feet of altitude for the quadricopter, so if I was to turn off my transmitter before turning off my copter, we'd have a spectacular crash, which makes for great internet television, but not so safe for the studio audience, so we're going to shut this down now. Once again, I'd like to remind you, if you are watching at home and you're live, you're welcome to enter your questions in the chat room. We already had somebody comment that the Jesse Pinkman costume was a little too loud. Hopefully we've mitigated all that crinkling for you. So, more fun with GoPros. As I mentioned, I went trick-or-treating and came back with a bunch of goodies, including the Genus GoPro cage. Now, this machined piece of aluminum turns your disposable GoPro into an indestructible GoPro. A couple of important features. I mean, the first one is evident right here. Look at this. This is a 52mm filter ring. So, if you love GoPros but you just wanted to put on a polarizer, no problem. Put it on right here. This will fit all kinds of housings. This will fit a GoPro with no housing when you add the shims, and they're labeled top and bottom. So if you take your GoPro out of its waterproof housing, you shim it up, put this shim on the top, this shim on the bottom, and it fits right in. It fits right into your GoPro cage. If, on the other hand, your GoPro is in its waterproof case, you can lose the shims, put them back in your trick-or-treating basket, and put the entire contraption right into this cage. A couple of other important features of the GoPro cage, you do have these holes cut out here and here so that you can connect your HDMI cable, you can connect your power cable, you can access the shutter and power buttons, right? So if you are flying in a squirrel suit, if you're driving the crash vehicle, if you're doing anything kind of dangerous and you want to preserve your badass GoPro Hero Black, get yourself a $99 Genesis GoPro cage. It's compatible with all the GoPro mounts right here with this standard GoPro, you know, GoPro mount adapter, but it's also got 30 quarter inch threads and 6 3/8 inch threads. So anything you're using on the set is going to allow you to mount this GoPro cage right to it. It's pretty fantastic. It's pretty inexpensive. So now let's go to Debbie with a question coming in from the internet.
Jesse, Alan would like to know, how difficult are those drones to operate and control? Does it take months of practice?
Alan, thank you for watching. And thanks for your question. How difficult is it to control those drones? Well, it's like Othello, you know, minutes to learn, lifetime to master. In about 25 minutes, we can have you taking off, turning around, and landing. But just like jib cinematography, there's an art to it, and you'll definitely want to spend a lot of time practicing. Hopefully that answers your question. I mean, they're easy enough to control, particularly the DJI Phantom. As I mentioned, it will get a GPS lock from several satellites. You can even turn it into what they call a GPS mode of flight, where if you were to let go of, let's say you're giving it some right throttle. If you're to let go of the right throttle, it will stop and stabilize itself with GPS satellites. To give you a comparison, when you take it out of GPS mode and into what they call attitude mode, if you hit right on the thumbstick, it's flying like this, you let go of the thumbstick, it'll sort of gently slope off to a stop. On the other hand, if you're in GPS mode, when you hit right on the thumbstick, it's gonna cruise to the right, and when you let go of that thumbstick, it's gonna stop and try to sort of fight back this way. What that's really helpful for, apart from precision flight, if it's a windy day and the wind is trying to push your Phantom this way, but you want it to hover, if you let go of both thumbsticks, the GPS satellites and the Phantom are gonna negotiate themselves to sort of keep it very stable. And again, the Zenmuse, the gimbal, when you combine the power of this gyro-stabilized gimbal with the power of the GPS-stabilized Phantom, you get a really good lock on your image. So, Alan, it's not easy to fly, no, but there are a lot of technological advancements working in your favor. All right. Thanks for your question coming in from the internet. So we were talking about the Genesis cage. We mentioned that it can both fit your GoPro with the underwater housing and without the underwater housing. It can fit your GoPro with the skeleton housing, which allows you to plug in the HDMI and the power cables. But Jesse, you might ask, GoPro 3 Black, that is so 1 month ago. What have you got for me now? And I'm glad you asked, because I've been trick-or-treating, like I said, and one of the goodies I got, GoPro Hero 3 Plus, in stock at Midtown Video, $399, the baddest, biggest, coolest, newest, HD-est, 4K-est GoPro available. Does it fit in the Genesis GoPro cage, you might ask? Yes, it does. All it needs is a couple of shims. You shim it, you stick it, you got a GoPro Hero 3 Plus in your Genesis Pro cage. Pretty awesome.